Today we're going to learn how to install a switch endstop on the Bigtree Tech SKR Pro version 1.1. Now here's a endstop that I purchased with my own money, just like the board, that I'll leave Amazon affiliate links in so you can find it, but let me show you the endstop real quick. For the endstop, we have our signal, which is in blue, our black, which is ground, and our red, which is voltage. Those correspond to pins inside here that will be connected to by our cabling. Now, our endstop cabling is based on signal being green, the red wire being voltage, and the black wire being ground. And we're going to use a notched connector to connect it. So in order to do this, what I need to do is, first of all, I'm going to put the endstop up here so you can see it. Then I'm going to take the connector over here and place it inside the connector. So it just slides right in here. Let me disconnect this for a second. So as you can see, the notched connector connects. And I'll put it back on here for a moment. Next, I'm going to connect this connector to our end stops. But I want to point out real quick, on our end stops, we have our X minimum, our Y minimum, our Z minimum. Then we have our X maximum, our Y maximum, and our Z maximum. So inside these pins here are our pins that correspond to these wires. So the first pin over here is going to be our voltage pin. The next pin over is going to be our ground pin, and then the final one is signal. And I'll show you a little bit about that in a few moments, but I'm going to connect the cable for now. And there we go. It's on the X minimum. Now, in order to load the actual firmware on this board, we need a micro USB adapter. So we're going to remove our TF drive and place it in the micro SD adapter. And we're going to plug that into the computer, and you're going to hear a beep. Okay, to start with, we've plugged the SD card into the computer, and it says firmware. Now it says file type cursor. There's been some debate that it might be a current file, which is perfectly fine, but I just wanted to point that out to people that are curious. So what we're going to do now, we're going to go over to the pins file for the SKR Pro version 1.1, and I'm going to show you the actual end stops. So we have our X minimum, our Y minimum, our Z minimum, then we have our X maximum, our Y maximum, and our Z maximum. As you can see, we have our voltage, which is 3.3 volts, our ground, and then our pin number. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you in Atom, with PlatformIO loaded, how it works. So right now I have the Marlin-Bugfix-2.0.x loaded. In order to load this, you need to download the Marlin firmware, unzip it, then go to File, and do Open Folder for the Marlin folder. So inside here, we're going to navigate around. I'm going to open up the Marlin subfolder. Then I'm going to go to the source folder. Then I'm going to go to the pins folder. And inside here, we're going to open up STM32. And we have our pins underscore Marlin, or excuse me, our pins underscore Bigtree underscore SKR underscore Pro underscore 1.1.h. our file. So we're going to open this up. I'm going to scroll down and show you where our pins are. These are the pins that correspond to the pins diagram. You can see them in order. Now that we understand that, that's where our actual settings come from for our individual boards. So I'm going to close out of the pins folder. I'm going to go to the core folder now, and I'm going to open up boards.h. Inside boards.h, I'm going to do a search on SKR underscore Pro, and I'm going to copy our board name, which is defined right here for pins. Now I'm going to close out of this, and I'm going to collapse these folders, and I'm going to go to the configuration.h. I'm going to do a search on motherboard, and I'm going to highlight board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB, and I'm going to paste the name of our board definition. And now I'm going to scroll up and I'm going to change define serial underscore port 0. I'm going to change that to a negative 1 for the 0. Now I'm going to do a search on Endstop. And right down here, we can see which actual Endstops are enabled. Currently, it's the X minimum, the Y minimum, and the Z minimum. Now, if we wanted to enable other ones, we'd remove the comments, for instance, this one. So now we have use X max. So over here, I'm going to show you something real quick. This has to do with Endstop pull-ups. This has to do with cleaning up your current, I believe, because you sometimes get in a float state. So I'll let you experiment with that on your own because it's not really relevant to this particular tutorial. But down here, I wanted to show you something. This is for our mechanical end stops. In order to use them, currently it's probably going to read that it's triggered for our X minimum that we're using. So in order to change that, we're going to change this to true. And that way it'll flip the logic from triggered to open. So in order to prepare now for a compilation of our changes, we need to go to the PlatformIO.ini, and right now our default environment is the Mega AT Mega 2560, which is not the chipset we're using. So we're going to do a search on SKR underscore Pro, and what we're looking for is BigTree underscore SKR underscore Pro. So we're going to page back up. And we're going to highlight the Mega AT Mega 2560 and paste over it. And that will give us the correct chipset for our default environment. So now we're going to compile and save. Okay, now that the compiling has finished, what we're going to do is check to make sure it compiled first by going to toggle build panel. And as you can see, it says success. So we're going to toggle the build panel back. And what we're going to do is we're going to check to see under .pio where it went. So we're going to go to build. And as you can see, there's a BigTree SKR Pro folder. So we're going to open that. And very, very low on the list, we see firmware.bin. So we're going to copy the path. And we're going to go over to run. And we're going to paste the path in and then press enter. And what we have here is our build. So we're going to copy that. Or better yet, we're going to go to send. And we're going to send it to the SD card that we looked at just a moment ago. And then we're going to go over to the SD card, and as you can see, we have firmware.bin, which is our compiled version of the firmware. Now that we have it removed from the computer, we're going to take the adapter and remove the TF card. We're going to place it in our board, making sure that we have our end stop over here already configured. We're going to also verify that our jumper is in the correct position, which is these two pins. And so now we're going to connect the big side of the USB cable to the board, and we're going to connect the small side to the computer, and you're going to hear a beep. And in the center, you can see that it's loading. Okay, we're in the print run folder for Pronterface. So we're going to open up Pronterface. We're going to connect to the 3D printer for the SKR Pro version 1.1. And we're going to check with a G code being M119 to check the status of our end stops. And as you can see, the one end stop that we actually flipped the logic on for inverting is open, and all the rest are triggered, but they're also unconnected. So what I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to trigger the end stop with my finger. So here we go. And as you can see, there's a light on. Now I'm going to check the end stop again by sending the M119 again for the command. And as you can see, it's triggered. So if I release my finger and then do the G code again, it now says open. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.